Hello, veteran 0-2 here, welcome back, and this is another episode of Final Fantasy VI. Backtrack to Nars off-screen, put Gaw back in my party, because he's going to be a lot more useful than Savin for a long time. This is going to be my party of choice for quite a while, actually. Edgar's got the tools, Gaw's got the ability to use rages, lock, and steal. Always gotta have a thief, treasure hunter in your party, and then Celeste, she can use magic. Everything I need, all in these characters right here. Savin and Cyan, don't need them. They're not that good. So yeah, let's go ahead and go to Kohlingen. Before you do go to this area over here, make sure you're equipped with the stuff that you want to be equipped with, because the monsters are stronger in this area over here. So directly to our northwest there is a town, but I'm going to skip going there for now, because there's somewhere I want to go up north from here, so let's go there. And yeah, I suppose I might as well show off my equipment in the status screen. Yeah, that's all the stuff I have equipped for Celeste. Ribbon and earring for her. All the stuff I got for Edgar. Yeah, on the males, I have them all equipped with green berets because they're good. Damn good. Yeah, with this equipment right here, I got 45% evasion percentage. So yeah, that's really good. Gaw's pretty good in the evasion percentage as well, with that equipment there. If I had a ninja gear for him, then, I'd equip it, but I don't. I'd rather have Locke have that instead. Ooh, look at this. We got a new enemy, a fossil dragon. I don't remember if this guy uses an attack that really sucks, but... yeah. What can we steal from this guy? Oh, yeah. Sandstorm. Ow. You can steal holy water. And, I think I'm gonna try using a Phoenix Down on this bastard. So I don't want him to use that fucking attack again. Yeah, but that guy drops a lot of gil when you beat him. But yeah, that Sandstorm Rage would be pretty good if I can encounter that guy on the belt. So yeah, stay out of the desert. Desert is pretty dangerous in this area. We have some more new enemies. We have Bloodfangs and Vultures. And let's use Flash. Yeah, that halves HP. That ability halves HP. It's pretty good. Yeah, I think it's time for some Guard Leader. I love this raise. It's one of my favorites. This map is all blown up like that. What the hell is this? Don't tell me it's another one of these kooky old men again. Oh man, it is. We can't let the world become too peaceful. Don't you see? People shine the brightest when they're at war. My Colosseum will be a monument to the glory of battle. If I can ever finish it, that is. No one will help me. Ha ha. Sounds like a waste of time to me. But anyways, if we come over here, we can get a hero's ring, which is essentially an earring and a Gigas glove all rolled into one. As a matter of fact, I'm going to give this thing to, no, not to Gaw. I'll give it to Edgar, actually, because some of his tools, like the Flash tool, are actually magical-based. And, yeah, this will replace the Gigas glove, basically. But, yeah, it will boost both physical and magical attack power by 25%. If you equip two Heroes Rings on one character, the effects do not stack for physical damage, only magical damage. So, two Heroes Rings is essentially the same thing as equipping two earrings. Plus, you get 25% extra physical attack power. But yeah, unfortunately, the physical attack power value does not stack. But magic does, for some reason. Oh, well. Yeah, I just wanted to pick that up. That way, Edgar's Flash tool can do a little bit more damage. Because that's going to be really, really useful for the next few areas. Yeah, it does a little bit more. It'll get more noticeable as he levels up and gets more magic power. Well, actually, Edgar's not going to be really going to be getting more magic power. I'm going to be putting most of my Esper bonuses for Edgar into strength. Once we get access to those Espers, that is. Really? What the hell are you doing giving me these weak-ass enemies? Welcome to the town of Kohlingen. Yeah. Scare the shit out of me, too. Let's check out the inn/pub. Wait a minute. I know that music. Oh, look who's here. Hey, buddy. What's going on? Oh. Oh, okay. How's your doggy? Anyways, if you, at this point, actually come here with three party members, you can recruit Shadow. However, there is still that 1 in 16 chance that he'll just leave whenever he wants. You know what? I'm not going to bother. But Shadow would be useful for the next area if there wasn't that risk of him running away. I really, really hate that. Yeah, we don't really need him anyways. I mean, hell, we got Edgar and we got Gaw and we're good to go. Celeste can cast magic. And Locke can steal shit. Yeah, we've already met that goofball. Wow, Tara did this? She fried a house, huh? Yeesh. That's unlucky. Jeez. The rest of the town's okay. Just that one house. Rachel's house? No. Haven't done that yet. Doing it soon enough in this episode. But yeah, let's check out the equipment here. Again, I don't think there's anything here I care about. Okay. Yeah, if you had Shadow in your party, you could buy some really nice items like flame water and lightning scrolls. Yeah, the damage for these is based on Shadow's magic stat. And they're pretty useful, but yeah, I'll be buying those later on. Not right now. Twist headband. Nah, not as good as a Green Beret. Green cherries? No, don't need anything there. If I do need anything in that shop, I can easily just go back to Figaro Castle and get it for half off anyways. An opera house, huh? Oh. Sounds exciting. A ghost in his basement? I think he's talking about Gaw's dad. Oh wait, no. He's talking about this place. He's not talking about Gaw's dad. I thought he said out east. Not east in this town. Anyways, over here we can get a chest with a Green Beret. It's a little hidden. But, yeah, we got plenty of Green Berets now. Green Berets will be useful for a very long time. This means some kooky old guys living down here. Treasure? What are you talking about? I guess we'll come back in there in a second. But yeah, let's go over to this house over here. Flashback time. Yeah, this music we're hearing right here is officially the, well, it's not the Locke theme, actually. I can't remember what this theme is called. It is a variation on Locke's theme, though. It's like a sadder version of it. Yeah, if you're wondering which piece of music is actually Locke's theme. Think back to the beginning of the game when the Moogles are saving Terra from those Imperial guards. You know, that's the Locke theme right there. Well, yeah, Rachel doesn't remember him. Look at that, more amnesia. Yay for amnesia. That is why Locke is the way he is. Well, yeah, like I said before in previous episodes, check every clock you see. go talk to her. So she's in some kind of suspended animation then? Wow. Nice job, old man. What legendary treasure? Of course, they're not going to tell us. You know, and this is where Celeste starts to realize why Locke is the way he is. See, I don't believe you get that little extra thing with Celeste going over there and looking at her. Unless she's in your party. Alright, so that's pretty much all we can do in Kohlingen. We get a little backstory on Locke, so from here... Oh, my map doesn't even have a red dot telling us where we need to go next. Well, we're going to be heading south. I know that. And we're going to be heading south in the next episode. That's all for this episode of Final Fantasy VI. In the next episode, we're going to head south towards Gidor. This is Veteran 0121. I'd like to thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.